guys, Banana Face here, and I have not made a video in a very long time. I'll be explaining reasons for that in future videos, but in today's video, I am going to be showing you my Suriname boa constrictor, and I might be showing you just a few tips and tricks to keeping them. Here we go. Alright, so I have him out just on the floor here, out of this cage, and he just shed, he just shed 2 days ago. So if you do not know, Suriname boas are part of the red-tailed boa family. So that means that their tail from, like, you know, maybe it's not very much of them. It's like a fifth of their body is more red than the brown. And other red-tailed snakes will have a lot more white than my Suriname does. But his red is looking very, very nice right today after a shed. And even all his browns, as you get closer to his head, are looking very, very nice. I love his head right now. It's nice and bright from his shed. So let's just start at the tail. So as you know, there's this red pattern. And on the side, it's like just red, black, and white, and speckers of brown. His underside is just, there's reds there, red, black, and white. But as you go down, the reds start to go away. And on the top, I like to say he has a Batman symbol because it kind of looks like a Batman symbol right there. And that basically just goes up all the way. And then he has this really cool pattern that goes all the way up his side body. But if he'll let me show you his belly right now, you'll see it's all freckled. And all of his belly, except for at his tail, is very freckled. That's just how he is. And if you go to the head area, the Batman symbol starts to just turn into a line. Sorry about the bad filming. I obviously haven't made a video in a very long time. You know, I'm getting back into it now. What I love is this red streak right on his head and the pink under it. And what I love about the boas is the coloring goes over their eyes. So their eye is colored as well. It's not just like black or red or anything. As you can see, he has nice black tongue. Yeah, he has got a very small head for a boa his age. I believe he is around 2 or 3. He is 6'1". I wouldn't believe it. He looks a lot smaller than 6'1", but he is, in fact, 6'1". And he's not acting very good for the camera. He is trying to hide, apparently, in my legs. Here's just a good angle of his side patterns while he crawls up my leg on this other side. So there is a lot of pink all along here. There's this cool red and black pattern that is all over, and then there's this kind of more faded dark pattern that's just like kind of a circle. So you can kind of see it on his black streaks right here. He does have a little bit of iridescence in the sunshine because I do have the windows open, and you can sort of see his iridescence. It kind of shines blue here. He's not actually blue, it's just the sunlight reflecting off his scales, which looks really good. Now, my snake is a Suriname boa, and his name is Sebastian, if I haven't already told you that. And he's very, very mellow. Other snakes might be a little bit crazy, you could say, and just going all over the place, checking things out. Some of them might get a little nippy, try to bite you, but Sebastian is very mellow. He never tries to bite you unless he's in feeding mode. And he doesn't move around that much. He likes to just go into dark cracks or crevices in his hideout. That's why I don't really let him in the couch, because he can go under it or in the cracks, and that'd be very bad for him. Now onto his cage. I'm using an exoteric cage. I don't know like the model or anything. But I like this cage a lot because it has this latch up here, so in case he gets the lock unlocked, then he won't be able to push this out. But I also love it because it's a a open or like a front door opening instead of a top door opening. So it's just a lot more convenient and easy. And it's just a simple lock. You push it down and open the door up. I don't know what gallon this is, but it's a big one. He's getting quite big, so in the near future we might have to get a bigger cage. We have a tree in here because he does like to climb sometimes. Especially when you put him away, he'll get on there. We have our homemade hideout, and we did have a piece of cardboard here, so like he wouldn't be bothered here. But actually fell off, so we're gonna get that soon. We have some foliage in the way at the moment. This cage did come with a rock background just to, you know, make it look a little bit better, and he might find it a little bit better. The thermometer, you should always have the thermometer in a snake cage. And just a rough rock here to help him when shedding. We have our water bowl, which at the moment is a little low. I'll have to fill that up. And we just use like this mulchy bark substrate for what he uses. We also have our heat pad just under here. It's pretty deep, it's in there, over here under his hide spot. So he can be warmer over here, but a little bit cooler over here. We have two lights. One of them is on right now. As you can see, this one is a daytime light. And then this one is a black light. You don't have to have this light, but this is a black light that turns on at night. Because I live up in New York, so it does get quite cold, so we don't want them to freeze at night. So we have this black light that turns on at night, so it won't be too bright. We can all get some sleep, he can get some sleep, but it'll still keep him heated with his heat pad. So that's his cage. Alright guys, so that's gonna really wrap up the me showing you my Suriname boa here, Sebastian. As you can see, he does love to climb all over you. You can just put him on you. I like to put him just around my neck. If you're watching TV or a movie and everything, and he'll just chill out. Boas are my favorite type of snake, and I think they're a great pet. And you can really tame them out. Most people think, you know, boas are mean, but no, they're not mean unless you don't handle them. If you have any questions, leave them down in the comments below. If I get enough, maybe I'll make another video answering all your questions about boa care. Or I'll just respond to you personally. That's about it. Thank you for watching. I'm going to be trying to make more videos now. Subscribe for more content. Like and share if you really like this video. And Sebastian says goodbye.